Yo, Adam Saxon with GuyNeCube, and have you ever wanted to allow an external user to publish a Power BI report using Power BI Desktop? I'm going to show you how to do it. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. A lot of folks have known that, yes, you can enable external users to get into your Power BI portal and they can have access to a given workspace and can actually edit content with inside of that workspace. They could also publish to that workspace using like the new feature inside of the web browser itself. But doing this from Power BI Desktop has always been a challenge. And the reason it's been a challenge is because Power BI Desktop doesn't natively support external users or business to business, but there was an update with Azure Active Directory that actually allows this to work. And I want to walk you through it. Before I do that, shout out to Ross Couldrey. I just want to give him kudos for pointing me this direction and showing me that this worked. All right, enough all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on GuyNeCube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. I'm inside of the GuyNeCube tenant. So I'm logged in with my asaxon at guynecube.com, and I'm inside of a workspace external publishing demo, and it's premium per user, so that's cool. And what I've done is I've provided access to an external user. In this case, it's the same name. It's in my Power BI cat.net tenant. So this is another user outside of guynecube.com that has access to this workspace and is listed as a member. So what I want to do is log in with that user to my guynecube tenant to be able to publish a report to this workspace. So let's jump over to Power BI Desktop. I've got my report. I'm ready to go. I'm not signed in to Power BI Desktop. We're going to go sign in. And we're going to enter in the email address that we want to sign in with. So in this case, it's going to be my Power BI cat.net user. Hit continue. You will get the initial sign-in dialog to sign into this user. This is where it gets a little tricky. Do not select this user. Click on use another account. You get this option here. It says sign-in options. We want to click on that and then sign into an organization. In this case, that is GuyNeCube. So I'm going to sign into GuyNeCube with a user that's an external user to GuyNeCube. So we'll hit next. And now it asks me, which user do you want to sign in? Now I want to sign in with my Power BI cat.net and bam, I'm in. You'll see there's some things that are not quite right. I think part of this is because Power BI Desktop itself doesn't necessarily recognize all of it. It's pulling this information from its Active Directory and not all of that information is set up. So I think if you did that for guest users, this would show up correctly. This is one oddity that I found when signing into Power BI Desktop with an external user. Let's keep going. So I'm now in GuyNeCube with this user. So what I want to do now is publish. And we'll say, yeah, sure. It'll show me the workspaces I have access to in the GuyNeCube tenant. So in this case, I'm going to say external publishing demo and then go ahead and select. And that succeeded. So let's go back. I'm logged back in with my GuyNeCube. This is my admin user. And you'll see here that we've got a report that's listed here. So this was actually published and it was published not too long ago. And if I go to settings of the data set, you can actually see that the data set was configured by the Power BI cat.net user. That's bananas. So the external user published the report from Power BI Desktop to the workspace. Oh my gosh, that's something that I know a lot of folks have been asking for in terms of this external user capabilities, and you could do it through the web browser, but now you can do it with Power BI Desktop. So there's one more thing Ross called out to me. If your organization has a default information protection label, in this case, GuyNeCube does. So when I publish a report from Power BI Desktop using my GuyNeCube account, it automatically applies general use to that workbook. Publishing it with an external user, the sensitivity label didn't get applied. I'm not quite sure why that is. Maybe that'll get updated in the future, but if you're using information protection labels or sensitivity labels, just be aware that that's the case. Another thing just to call out is this workspace is a premium per user workspace, which means they have to have premium per user as well. And so in this case, the external user ended up having a premium per user trial, but you can assign a license to their guest account as well. If the workspace is backed by premium capacity, then it should just work even with free users. So just be aware of that, that licensing does apply. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What did you think? Is that something you've been looking to do for external users to be able to publish from desktop? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.